My name is Honorable Dennitah Ghati. I am a Member of Parliament in the Kenya National Assembly, representing persons with disabilities. I also represent Africa region to the Commonwealth Parliamentarians with Disabilities Network, which is a newly formed wing of the CPA, where we champion issues of parliamentarians with disabilities. As you are aware, Kenya Parliament is basically a bicameral parliament. The Speaker of the National Assembly, the Honorable Justin Muturi, is the chair of the Executive Committee of the CPA Africa region. And I'm glad that really he has been very, very instrumental as a CPA head of Africa to help us champion the formation of the new Commonwealth Parliamentarians with Disabilities Network that I chair. One of the most important role as a legislator, basically for persons with disabilities, is really looking at the various legislations in terms of scrutinizing or scrutiny of the legislations that we have. When a bill, for example, comes into the House, this is a bill that has to go through committee stage. And at committee level, a committee stage of the House is when, as a member of parliament, for example, representing persons with disabilities, my role is to really look at this bill, this law, to ensure really that it catches the interests and concerns of persons with disabilities. And immediately we get out of the first reading and public participation, then we get into second reading. Second reading, basically, in the House is where we get general views, you know, members debate, and I also debate and give input into the bill. That is the stage in which I basically also really have to read and given a lot of inputs into this bill. So the committee stage of the bill now in the House allows for a lot of amendments. That is the only stage where, as a member for parliamentarians with disabilities or issues disability, I have to really scrutinize the bill to ensure that even within, when the bill reaches a committee stage of the House, then this is a bill that is almost complete, and it really must have put on board the concerns of the people that I represent. So generally, a member of parliament belonging to a committee, for example, that looks at issues of disability in Kenya parliament is the Committee of Labour. And therefore, as a member of parliament, to belong to a committee like that must be basically show also interest in the committee that you want to serve. Majority of members of parliament with disabilities fall in the committee, that is the Committee of Labour, to be able to effectively monitor and effectively input and strengthen the various laws that exist in terms of persons with disabilities. In parliament also, our standing orders in Kenya basically allow for caucuses and subcommittees where ideally members of parliament could have an issue that they feel that they can actually conglomerate, come together and debate away from the major departmental committee, for example. And that is where we have the subcommittee, for example, like the Disability Parliamentarians Association, KDIPA, where members of parliament with disabilities are able to sit together, to dialogue together on issues, because they are the ones living that life. All right, and after the committee stage, basically we get now into the post-passage stage, and this is basically a stage where our bills now get into the implementation phase. And in the House, we have a committee that is called the Committee of Implementation. This is a committee that reports periodically on the various resolutions and the various efforts that they have followed, and the various efforts that various institutions have so far taken into consideration in terms of ensuring that the various bills and legislations that have come from the House have actually been followed to the letter, to ensure that persons with disabilities are benefiting from the various laws that we have in this country. Countries that ratified CRPD, like Kenya, are actually required by law to make sure that they domesticate the concerns of CRPD into the various constitutions and the various laws that are here. So the work that I do as a member of parliament for persons with disabilities, as a member of parliament who actually champion the region of Africa to the CPA, in terms of disability issues is basically to ensure that all these documents and all these treaties and all these laws that our countries have ratified on an international level are able to trickle down to the various parliaments or to the various countries. And that is what we do when we now we look at the various committees to ensure that our committees in parliament are aware. So even within parliament, we realize that many a times you will notice that you will have to actually, if need arises, you will have to request the speaker to actually conduct a capacity building of members of parliament on issue disability. Issues to do with understanding the various laws, the CRPD and the AU Disability Protocol. Now in CPA, where I champion issues disability of members of parliament to the CPA, my role there is basically to also ensure that you know, we pay visit to our various legislatures to ensure that legislatures are very much aware of the various laws that exist internationally and how then do various legislatures in Africa, for example, ensure that they align their parliaments or they align their constitution or they align their laws to the CRPD, which basically ties countries to make it easier for persons with disabilities, to make it easier for legislatures with disabilities to be able to actually undertake their work. Finally, I wish to say that it is my hope that as we move forward, members of parliament will actually be disability aware, they will be disability friendly, they will be disability sensitive, to be able to articulate issues that affect persons with disabilities. And for me as a member of parliament from Kenya and as a member of parliament representing the region of Africa to the CPA, I really want to also call upon parliament and government to ensure that their various disability commitments really translate into disability budgets so that issues that affect persons with disabilities are able to be taken into account and they are able to be prioritized.